الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And good morning, Instagram fam, friends and followers of Asafi. Welcome to another installment in our running series, Revert Reflections. And under the current theme of what sets Islam apart from other faiths. And this week we've been talking about the fact that in Islam, deeds matter. And we supported this from a number of angles thus far. So at the outset, we said one of the indications that in our religion, deeds matter, is that deeds are the partner of faith. And wherever one goes, the other follows. And we cited some verses from the Quran and some ahadith, which indicate that deeds and faith go hand in hand. They are part and parcel of one another in Islam. Then yesterday, we continued in that vein, mentioning that deeds matter because faith is, in our religion, faith is deeds and deeds are faith. They are one and the same. And we mentioned some ayat and some ahadith where Allah and His Messenger have indicated that faith is deeds and deeds are faith in Islam. Today, we will continue again in that vein, stressing the fact that deeds matter in Islam. And this is indicated, another way that this is indicated, I should say, is that there are consequences associated with doing good on the one hand and failing to do good or doing bad while saying we believe on the other. So the presence of consequences for doing good deeds, and the presence on the other hand of consequences for failing to do good deeds or for doing evil deeds or wicked deeds is a clear indication that deeds matter in Islam. Now let's consider some verses from the Quran which are indicative of the presence of these consequences. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Az-Zukhruf, which is the 43rd surah, the 43rd chapter of the Quran, verse number 72, he says, وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. He says, this is the paradise which you will be rewarded for the deeds you used to do. How did they get paradise? They got paradise because of the deeds they did. The deeds had what? Positive consequences and yielded amazing results. Another example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr, the 15th surah, verses number 92 and 93, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَوَرَبِّكَ لَنَسْأَلَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says, so by your Lord, we will certainly question them all about what they used to do. Allah is going to question us about what we did. Why would He question us about what we did if what we did not matter? Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in Surah As-Safat, which is the 37th chapter of the Quran, He mentions a series of verses in which He speaks about and describes the gardens of bliss in paradise. And He concludes those descriptions by saying, لِمِثْلِ هَذَا فَلْيَعْمَلْ الْعَامِلُونَ. He says, for the likes of this, let the strivers strive. In other words, let those who do good motivated by the hopes of reaching paradise, that they will get paradise if they do good deeds. Again, this is another clear indication that deeds matter. Because why? Because you get rewarded for those deeds. We're being incentivized to do good. That means good deeds or doing deeds matter in Islam. On the other hand, not doing what we're supposed to do, not doing the good deeds, has consequences as well. Or doing bad deeds has consequences as well. Another indication, a clear indication that deeds matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah As-Sajdah, which is the 32nd chapter of the Quran, verse number 14, He says, وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْخُلْدِ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. He says, and taste the torment of eternity for what you used to do. And He tells us in Surah At-Tawbah, which is the 9th chapter of the Quran, verse number 95, He says, وَمَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. He says, hell will be their abode as a recompense for what they committed of sinful deeds. And besides, in these two verses, Allah has mentioned the potential punishment in the hereafter But Allah also tells us, besides this potential punishment thereafter, that doing bad deeds has consequences in this world as well. These bad deeds, they cover the heart and seal it shut such that guidance and faith cannot enter it. Allah says, "Kalla bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun." But no, he says, but no, in fact, their hearts have been stained and sealed by all the evil they used to commit. Now think about this, brothers and sisters. We started at the outset mentioning how there are some Muslims who say, what matters is the heart. Allah knows my heart. You don't know my heart. When they're doing the wrong things or failing to do the right things, they justify this behavior by saying that faith is something which is divorced from deeds, and they say sometimes explicitly or implicitly, deeds don't matter. What I do doesn't matter. What matters is what? How my heart is, or the faith that's in my heart. Well, these verses, brothers and sisters, what we've heard today, just a few verses, and we could mention many more, but for the sake of time, we've limited ourselves. Three verses would show us the consequences on the positive side of doing good. And three verses would show us the consequences for not doing the right things, or the consequences for failing to do good, or doing the wrong things. If deeds didn't matter, brothers and sisters, would there be any reward for doing good deeds? Would there be any punishment for doing evil deeds or failing to do good? There wouldn't be. And this is another clear indication, the presence of consequences is another clear indication that in our faith, one of the things that sets our faith apart from other faiths is the fact that in our faith, deeds matter. We have to understand this, we have to internalize this, and we have to act accordingly. We have to be the people who don't believe, don't allow themselves to believe that it doesn't matter, my heart's pure. It doesn't matter the fact that I do all of these wrong things and all of the right things that I'm supposed to do, many of them I don't do, that doesn't matter. We can't allow ourselves to be from those people, because in our faith, what sets our faith apart from other faiths is the fact that in our faith, deeds matter. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.